Hi everyone, we're glad to be here to talk about the vertical communication networks of the Sun Belt State University. I'm Skylar.
I'm DA.
I'm Yinjia.
And I'm Yun.
Okay, so today we will focus on this point. First, we'll give you a brief introduction of the communication issue that the Dean Wilson has faced already. And then we'll identify the target audiences that she needs to communicate with. Next, we will talk about her strengths and weaknesses of her communication performances. And finally, we will give her some recommendations to improve her current performance. First, as we all know, Dean Wilson has faced some serious communication issue when she wants to implement her outreach strategy. And we thought one of the problems is that her subordinates have no idea about what Dean Wilson is achieving. And based on the Beyond the Bubble, we all know that if a leader wants to implement a strategy, the first thing she needs to do is to let her employees know what the strategy is. But she didn't do well at it. So we think because of her lack of communication, and then a tension between Dean Wilson and her colleagues is showing, and their relationship is just broken up. Her relationships just have some problems, so which is bad for her to implement her strategy. And the internal communication should be improved. After all, Dean Wilson is a dean of the faculty, and the first important thing she needs to do is to communicate with her employees effectively and frequently. But we don't think she did a very good job in internal communication, although she probably did well externally. Yeah. So first, we will identify the target audience. Considering of her position in the university, we divided this group into three parts. First one is upper management, including the president of the university and the chief academic affairs officer. Okay, we think they are the people Dean Wilson should report to if she has some problems or have some difficulties needs to be resolved. But we know based on the case, all the upper management thought she did a very good job internally and give her really high regard, but we all know that employees didn't think so. So we think the upper management need to know the real condition of EHBJ, like what happened internally and what employees are unsatisfied, which part they are unsatisfied, yeah. And provide some support when the colleague faces difficulties, like if Dean Wilson has some financial problems, the upper management should be the first person to provide the financial support to her to resolve these difficulties. The second part is EHBJ faculty has. These people are the lower level managers than the Dean Wilson, and they actually the deliver in the people channel. They receive messages from Dean Wilson, and they deliver these messages to other employees. So we think they're very important in strategy implementation process, because if they understand clearly about the strategy, then the employees have the chance to know about it. Yeah, and they need to communicate the core message of the strategy to faculty members. Like I said, just delivers message clearly to make sure the whole process is successful. Third, beside, they need to take charge when Dean Wilson is away. We can say that all the employees have no idea what happened when the Dean Wilson is out of campus, and we assume that there might be some problems happened when she out of her campus, and they have no way to find help. Then they think the Dean Wilson didn't do a very good internal job, and we think so. The other faculty should be responsible for it, because they are also the part of the university, and they have. They have the responsibility to help the Dean Wilson to make everything in the faculty orderly. So the third part is faculty members. They are the ones who is really doing the work because they're the executor of the strategy. They should understand all of it and really implement it into reality. And besides, we think they have a clear understanding about students' needs. Why we mention students here, because we think students are the ones who really get benefits from the strategy. So it's important and necessary to know what the students are really need, what they want. And if we know their needs, we can find a more proper, we can find the resources more properly, yeah, based on their needs. And finally, they are the first people to identify issues within the college. We need to know what's the condition of this strategy. We need to know what happened if we implement it in this way. And Dean Wilson need to understand the condition and the problems of the strategy from these people. So they're also important in the communication activities. Next, and then Yan will introduce the strengths of them.
Okay, so now I will tell you about the strength of Dean Wilson. So the first thing we should notice about the case is the fact that Dean Wilson actually understands the need to build relationship with her employees. She tried to do that by set up policy for establish a casual conversation. The first policy is open door, which is held weekly, and the second one is coffee with the dean, which is held monthly. So the main purpose of both policies was to help Dean Wilson to be closer to her employees so she can get immediate feedback from them. Dean Wilson also tried to make her employees feel more connected to her by maintaining a high level of visibility even when she has to travel a lot. She still sent a faculty member birthday cards, and she also tried to invite employees to have lunch with her at least once a year. So it's clear that Dean Wilson did understand the need of face-to-face communication, which according to Gauman 2011 is the most preferred, proactive, and powerful medium. So the next strength of Dean Wilson is that she values inputs from faculty members and students. So Dean Wilson tried to make her employees feel more involved in their planning process by forming a planning committee consisting of department heads and several senior faculty members. She also cared about employees' thought, as she was the first one to ask for a review of her performance as dean. So there's no doubt that that Dean Wilson really value the power of listening, which according to Groswell will help her to have better understanding of her audience and help reveal new insights. So the third strength of Dean Wilson is she did a good job boosting employee morale. So at that point, the university was facing a financial crisis, was facing a financial crisis, which can result in low employee morale if not managed well. But Dean Wilson was working with department heads to come up with strategic plans to have the college remain a high level of enrollment. Funding's need for faculty development were met, and the students were considered among the strongest, and 14 new faculty members were hired in that sixth year. So as a result, faculty morale appeared to be high, and all leaders in the university held Dean Wilson in high regard. So that's the end of my part, and now DA will talk about Dean Wilson's weaknesses.
Right, so the weaknesses of the vertical communication network at the college. So the first weakness that we found relate to the fact that Dean Wilson was always away from campus. She was always traveling, and this led to the fact that she has a low level of involvement in internal activities. And while she's away, she fails to establish a clear communication process with the faculty members and the faculty heads. This led to the fact that Dean Wilson was unaware of what was happening inside the college, and all the faculty members and faculty heads were unaware of what Dean Wilson was traveling for. And this led to the fact that Dean Wilson was unaware of the dissatisfaction among the faculty members, and she only found out about the dissatisfaction after the evaluation process. The second weakness that we found with the vertical communication network at the college was that there was no room for employees to really voice their concerns. From reading the case, Dean Wilson set up one lunch meeting with faculty members once a year, and we feel that one lunch meeting per year is obviously not enough to build a relationship with somebody. And since they are only meeting with Dean Wilson once a year, we feel that they are less likely to be critical of things that are happening inside the college, and they're less likely to criticize the dean since they don't have the relationship with her yet. And obviously, when Dean Wilson is away from campus, the faculty members do not have a platform to really reach out to her and to let her know of all the things that are going on inside the college. So the third weakness was that there was no platform for the faculty members to exchange ideas with Dean Wilson. So from Beyond the Babel, we know that employees, they like to be a part of the strategy planning process. They like their voices to be heard. But in this case, Dean Wilson failed to establish a platform where employees can share ideas, exchange ideas with her, and to be really be a part of the strategy planning process. So that's why it resulted in the fact that the faculty members and the faculty heads were unaware of the outreach strategy. They didn't really know what it was. And in conclusion, we feel that the outreach strategy was not well communicated to the whole college. Another weakness that we found was that there was low degree of media richness from the vertical communication process within the college. Most of the times, Dean Wilson communicated with the faculty members and faculty heads through memos and letters. And obviously, from what we've learned in class, long memos and long letters are obviously not the best way to communicate with employees to really show them the benefits of the new strategies. So I bring in the feel part of the action equation here because memos and letters are very unlikely to really make people have a real emotional connection to their job, which results in the fact that employees are less likely to change their behaviors to adapt to the strategies. Next one. So I've touched you guys a lot about how Dean Wilson communicate with her subordinates, but we also feel that there's a lack of communication between Dean Wilson and upper management at the university as well. From reading the case, we found out that there was no real communication system between Dean Wilson and upper management, which resulted in the fact that they were unaware of the lack of support from the university development office for Dean Wilson, and there was no assistance provided to Dean Wilson, even though she was overwhelmed with the amount of work that she had to do. She was always traveling. She did most of her job inside airports, which is unacceptable for somebody of her status. So we feel that in order for us to improve the whole vertical communication process within the college, she first needs to improve the communication with the upper management. So now Yanjia will provide some recommendations that we have.
Okay, now let's talk about our recommendations. Build a new communication system. This is a process of listening and talking. First, we need to realize the truth that different people have their own preference for methods to send and receive information. Thus, we need to use a variety of media channels to ensure that we can reach out to more people. Some people prefer to use social media to receive information, and others may rely heavily on traditional media. Second, it is impossible for Wilson to communicate with all employees. Because of this situation, it is necessary for her to regularly communicate with the leadership team. For example, Dean Wilson can learn about what is going on in the other departments by communicating with the heads from each department. She can also understand EHBJ students' current situation and their needs based on the feedback from EHBJ's supervisors. Third, according to the case, Dean Wilson's colleagues feel disappointed due to her performance. However, Dean Wilson did not realize their certification before reading her report related to her performance. It can be inferred that no one spoken up prior to this time. Thus, generally, employees are reluctant to deliver bad news to top management because some people are afraid of leaving a bad impression on leaders or even fear retaliation. Therefore, Wilson should provide more channels for full faculty members to let them express their opinions. For example, the usage of the suggestion box means that the information is anonymous. In that situation, people may feel free to use this method to offer their advice about the school. Next, focus communication effort on department heads. This is the information I want to share it with you. According to Beyond the Bubble, the people channel generates an active interchange of knowledge and ideas among employees and leaders, rather than a passive cascade of information. It provides precise and tools to help engage leaders and employees in an ongoing conversation about strategy. So people have an opportunity to increase their understanding of strategy and offer their ideas and perspectives on how to improve it and execute better. Thus, we advise the school to designate and train department heads to be the people channel. Implement new culture at HBG. We want to ensure that full faculty members can speak up rather than worry about how they may suffer from retaliation when they choose to tell the truth. Thus, we think that Davidson should build a policy to prevent faculty members from receiving unfair treatment. Second, reward employees who stand out and work hard. This can motivate employees to be more active in participate in internal affairs because people tend to spend time and energy on things which can fit for their needs. Davidson should take team building activities into consideration because this can help Davidson to build a good relationship with her colleagues. If more employees like Davidson, they tend to support and trust her. Last, ask employees to complete the employee satisfaction survey so Wilson can learn about where she can make adjustments and make improvements. More face-to-face communication platform. According to the Beyond Bubble, if employees believe leadership doesn't involve them in decision-making and therefore doesn't make good decisions, leadership must implement a very visible process for employee involvement. According to a case, we can say Davidson is always away from campus. Therefore, she cannot properly communicate her strategies with faculty members. In the future, we hope that Davidson can regularly communicate with her colleagues. If Davidson cannot have one-on-one meeting with her colleagues, video conference can be another good choice. Keeping in touch with her colleagues can make them have a sense of belonging. Now here is a chart about communication network recommendations. You can see audience consists of the leadership team and non-managerial employees, which will advise dealers and use different channels to reach out different audiences. So that's all. Thanks for your time.